Good morning, everyone. We'll give it time for folks to hop on. I think I might be about a minute early. Yesterday, we made this card, a light version with the, a light version with the shimmering vellum. And today, we're gonna do this darker version because I had an idea while I was making this card that butterflies would look good on trellises. Good morning, Kelly. Good morning, Lynn. Good morning, Diana. Hello, everyone. Hi, Jewel. Nice to see everyone this morning. What a beautiful day, but then we're gonna have rain. So I have my coffee and cat is fed and no interruptions. I love it. Peggy, I totally get that. Oh yeah, if I don't feed the kitties in the morning, forget it, I can't live. Especially the one, Miss Jingles. Everything has to be timed, and if she gets hungry, she comes in and wakes me up. So, which is fine. Thank you, Donna. Thank you for sharing. I appreciate it. That's funny. Hi, Beverly. Good morning, Mary. Good morning, everyone. Look at everyone hopping on here. Hi, Linda. Let's see. Hi, Sandra. Hi, Peggy. Carrie. Hello, Jewel. I think I'm caught up there. Good. I like to say hello to everybody. If I miss you, I'm sorry. It rolls through so quick. I tried to roll back and say hello to everyone. this is fun paper, the shimmer vellum. Here yesterday we did with the Quiet Meadow set. And then today I'm going with, what is this? Brilliant Wings. Added the shimmer paper to my next order. I love this shimmer paper. You're gonna love this. The Brilliant Butterfly, I did this. Butterfly Brilliance. I know a lot of people have ordered this because I think, if I remember correctly, I was giving a half a pack of vellum away with the, if you ordered that from me, if I remember that correctly. Sometimes I forget what specials that I've done. But now, and of course I showed how to color vellum at that point and this and that, but now we have this beautiful shimmer vellum. That is absolute, and you can see, guys, I am cutting this up like crazy, okay? Comes in all of the in colors. So it's Fresh Freesia, Polished Pink, Evening Evergreen, Soft Succulent, and Pale Papaya. They're all in here. And, you know, I'm kind of pairing it. I love this paper. I gotta say, you know, sometimes you get paper and you can use it all the time. And I'm finding that this Bloom Where You're Planted paper has my eye. It's just something that I keep going back to. So that's wonderful. And now I did tone on tone. Okay, so, but we're going to look at a couple of things here. Let me move this card out of the way. And the only color we're going to use today is Evening Evergreen. So yesterday I went ahead because it does take time, but I also am not set up to make comments yet on YouTube. Oh, okay, Beverly, I understand that, but thank you for watching. Always, you guys, you can always watch the replay. You know, people are busy. It's the summer. You might be on vacation. You might have grandchildren and can't get to watch at night. You know, you might be going back to work now, you know, and not able to watch during the day. You can always watch at night, always, or anytime. So here's what I did with the inside of this card. And I really used this DSP. I wanted the butterflies to be almost like there was like a lot of greenery or ivy even behind the trellis. So that's what I thought of. But here is my little cup from yesterday. Isn't this funny? New overactive kitty, LOL. Lynn rescued a kitty. And so I believe the kitty is very happy that it's very fed and rescued and just happy kitty. They're very, very sweet. I love that. So what I did was I took all of my in colors here and I just did every single butterfly. And then I even did, because I love the color, gorgeous grape. Because I wasn't really sure with the gorgeous grape. Your feed keeps through. Oh, I'm sorry. See the gorgeous grape right here? Donna says her feed keeps freezing. It could be a Facebook thing. I don't know. There was a lot of things go on with computers the other day. I have no idea. But I wanted you guys to see, like, I'm going to do tone on tone with the fresh freesia on fresh freesia. Okay? But here's the gorgeous grape with the fresh freesia on top of it. And look at how beautiful that looks with a little bit of a darker color underneath it. Same tone in the purples, but just a little bit of a darker color. But I find it best with this set because the butterflies are all together. Now, I know a lot of people, thanks for sharing, Mary. Thank you. I love the butterfly color. Well, I paired the butterflies with the in colors just to use the Shimmer Vellum. But like this set comes with all of the butterflies together, okay? And I know a lot of people that have bought a second set and cut them to have individuals. It's a fantastic set. And then the dies. So what I did was I stamped the entire thing. And then the dies. Look at all these dies you get. The dies right here are all together. And it fits over top of this. Well, actually like that. Okay. So it fits like that. So you could cut them all out together. And then after you get them out together, here are all the individual ones that are detailed for them. So that is just like too cool. That is just this is an awesome set. This is a really nice butterfly set. I'll say that. And like I said, a lot of people I saw had bought the stamp set twice and cut one apart. So that's kind of fun. Our shelters are overcrowded with kittens. I know. I think, Kelly says, bless your heart for adopting. Our shelters are overcrowded with kittens. And I think the story I got is that a mama kitty had kitties in their shed. And so this is one of the babies. So I'm calling it adopted. And I guess she's taking care of the mama too. So hi, Carol. So what I did was I stamped each and every one, the whole entire butterfly, because I know I'm going to use them, okay, the whole thing, in every single color. I cut everything out, and then I went ahead and I started to put things together. So now I have the most pretty, he's only 1 3/4, love it. He needs you, Lynn, I know. You'll have him fattened up and happy, and if he's running around, he's happy, we know that. So now I'm just going to put my butterflies in here, my extras, to use on other projects. That's the greatest thing about that set, is that after you do something like this, you have a lot to work with for other cards. Okay, so I used Evening Evergreen as a base. And like I said yesterday, I'm really starting to fall absolutely in love with this color, even though it's the summer. Because the minute I saw it, I thought, oh, okay, Christmas, I won't use it. I'm using this like crazy. And then I used a piece of this DSP from the Bloom Where You're Planted. Okay, it's the other side of this one that we used yesterday. So yesterday we used the brick, and then this is the other side of it. So a good way to use up your DSP and use it wisely. So this will go in here, and we're gonna stamp on this. This is from Color and Contour Dyes. So let's go ahead and do that. This piece of DSP is 5 by 3 3/4. Now, we're on red rubber, so we don't have to worry. We have a rescue cat. This is what Peggy says. That was left behind when the neighbors moved. She's a sweet cat. Love them. Oh my goodness. I know, tell the strays. I know. I have 2 strays in the backyard. One I can't get near, but he eats. And he'll like hide, and I see him peeping out. I see his little eyes peeping, And I'm like, I know you're hungry. So I feed him. So, okay. So this card right here, I used hand-penned. Hi, Patty. I used hand-penned right here for this card where I use, I love this, thanks. And then I used anything as possible. But the greatest thing about making a card like this, because there's no sentiment here, okay? Of course, there's no sentiment with our Shimmer Vellum, right? You can use any sentiment you want. So I'm going to switch the sentiments today. And I'm going with flowers of friendship. I'm going to do life is better with friends like you. And little card, big thanks, which I absolutely love that saying. And I love the way that these are like penned through here. Hi, Susan. Thank you, Susan. I'm so glad you're on here. Everything's mailed, okay? If you ordered from me last month or even 2 months ago, hi, Marie, everything is mailed, okay? Everything finally came in yesterday. And so my strawberry people that got their class, they got their email with their PDF and the video. And when you get that, that means things have been mailed. So everything came in and they've all been mailed out. Adhesive packages are mailed out. If you've ordered from me last month, that stamp sets came. Everything came yesterday. I was so happy. Oh, thank you, Susan. I was just so happy that all of a sudden I got two shipments right after I got off of live. Boom, boom. I had like two things show up. And I was just so thrilled. And then for my team, if you're on here, yes, the card share, the swaps, they're mailed out too. I was a mailin' fool yesterday and this morning too. I've already been to the post office to take some things. If they won't fit in the mailbox, I don't like to bog down my mail carrier. So the post office is a mile away. So that's what I do. So let's go ahead and stamp this. Life is better with friends like you. We're going to use Evening Evergreen. And I'm going to stamp this right here in the center. Just like that. And then what I did on this card right here in the inside, I cut these little butterflies out. Love shipments. I drop everything and open it right away. I know. I'm the same way. I get a box. I'm like, ooh, look what I got. Yeah, so I have to open it. So what I did here was I cut in that set. There's a large and small to cut out. And so I cut one of each. And then on this one, we're going to use the small fresh freesia and then the larger pale papaya and the larger polished pink. Just using up what I've already cut, which is just wonderful. Okay, so let's put these on. And I realized that because this is Shimmer Vellum, I might want a large one up here. Yeah. And that, no, wait, let me get my colors right that I want. We'll do pink up here. We'll do purple here. And we'll do pale papaya here. That looks pretty. I like that. Okay. So what I noticed is when you use glue dots, because this is shimmer and color, you really don't see them. Which is wonderful. So I'm just going to stick that in the middle and put that one right there and just come through here with some nice glue dots and make our pretties. So I just cut a bunch of stuff out yesterday because I really didn't know what I was, how it was, this was going to go. Oh, thank you, Susan. Thank you. I love the Shimmer Vellum. It's so cute. Just wonderful, something just a little different. It's like permanent wink of Stella on vellum with color. And what better colors to use but those new in colors? I love the new in colors. I have not heard anybody yet say they don't like the new in colors. Look how pretty that looks on there, right? Some butterflies with some greenery. Let's go ahead and put this on. And then reward myself. That's good, Beverly. With opening the package, I know. I just ordered the Shimmer Vellum last night. I hope it doesn't take long to get there either. Most everything that I ordered that came was ordered May 31st, and yesterday was the 8th. So I live in Tennessee, And like I always say, I live in Hooterville, so it takes another day, like, for things to get here. Look at how pretty that looks. So it took a little while to get here. But then again, we did have a day of holiday, so, you know, that happens too. So this looks great on that. Evening Evergreen is 8.5 by 5.5, scored at 4.25. Look how pretty that is. Let me smash that down in there real good. Now let's move this to the side, and then let's go ahead and attach our lattice. And the lattice kind of has like, you can tell which side is the back. Like I could tell this is the back. It's kind of flat. You can feel it if you get up close on it. And what I do with the lattice is, now this piece of DSP is 5.25 by 4, is I just put a dot. Hello, Lisa. Thank you for joining. Thanks for dropping in this morning. I just put a dot where the solids are. Okay, and I swear they designed this just for us to be able to glue it down, which I'm going, thank you. So I just put a little dot there. And I'm thinking this little diamond shape didn't pop out of there. Yeah, that's how that has to go. Okay, good. And then I'm just gonna put this here, like it's trellis outside going up a nice wall of greenery. Hello from Wisconsin. Bet it's early there. Okay, now this can go down on our card front, and we're gonna put this down flat. Oh, I wanted to show you, do you see how this is frayed? This is DSP, okay? Do you see how that's frayed right there? I always keep an old nail file, and I mean, like, look, it's old, okay? You don't want to really use a new one because you don't want to, you know, really sand the paper. But if you take the nail file and then you just gently come across that fraying right there, that little fuzziness, and because the nail file is old, see, it took it right down, took it right away. I mean, you know, you don't really want to use one that is brand new, okay? So right there, and we'll put this down just like this. Hi, Mary. Here we go, right here. Okay, now we're gonna make our thanks. So I want to get all my flat down and pushed down, glued. Let's go ahead. This is just a piece of scrap white, and I'm going to put little card, big thanks. I love where they've penned this. It looks like it is, you know, written with a pen. Oh, yeah. Thank you, Lisa. And I love big thanks on this, so I'm going to stamp that right there. And I checked it out yesterday, and it does. I have my double oval punch. I love this double oval punch. It does fit right in there. Isn't that nice in that little part? I'm gonna punch that out. And then I'm gonna take my shimmer vellum here, and this is the soft succulent, and I'm going to make the back. And this is how easy it is to make this little element right here. Now, because this is shimmer vellum, you could use seal. I would not use, yes, it's 9 a.m. here. Okay, Lisa, I thought so. So you don't want to use liquid glue, okay? So you could use seal, Stampin' Seal Plus. And then I'm going to use glue dots right here. I'm just going to put two. So you kind of want, you don't want to use liquid glue, okay? Because this is shimmery. That's why I like my punches quick. Yes, I so agree. Oh, and they've taken so many punches away, you know, and yeah, I know. Yeah, I love punches. I totally agree, especially when you're making card kits to send out. It is so much easier to punch than it is to constantly roll stuff through. And now we're going to use some dimensionals here, just two, right there. That's, yeah, I agree. The punches are quick. Punches are quick. Right here. We're going to put this right down here. And I'm going to go to the edge of the card here because I can, just to show that that is just a little bit different. Isn't that pretty with the lattice? I love that. Okay, so let's see. We're done with this. We're going to color now. We talked about yesterday that what is back in stock are, yay, the in-color jewels. Yay that they're back in stock, okay? I am totally out of fresh freesia. So I thought today was the perfect day to go ahead and color some rhinestones. So here's my butterfly. This is the little fresh freesia one, so cute. And I'm going to place a glue dot here, right here, where you can't, you know, it won't show through. And then I'm gonna put it right here. And you want, oh, look at that, it's still on my tool. Here we go. It's like, why didn't that stick? Okay, so we have our wings that will kind of fly up. Okay, we'll put dimensionals on this in just a few minutes. So let's go ahead and make all of our butterflies. And like I said, yesterday evening, I just sat here and I stamped and I cut out, I die cut everything. And it was just so much fun. And like I say, I have a whole cup full of butterflies to pick from, make nice thank you cards with. So I'm going to put this right here. And you just need one when you do something like this, because you definitely want these wings to fly, okay? All right, now let's move those aside and let's bring in some blends and some basic rhinestones. This is what I'm giving away this month with a $35 order. I wasn't sure what was going to be back in stock and when, so I just went with easy peasy. For right now, I colored a larger one right here in soft succulent, but I actually wanted my smaller, two smaller ones here. So that's why that one's on there colored. So I'm going to use a large one. Well, actually, let's do the pink first. This is polished pink, and I'm going to use the nib tip of the dark polished pink. Okay, what? Oh, thank you, Kelly. Thank you. She said she loves the vellum for the wings. I save them for sample. That's so sweet. Lynn saves my cards. I love that. Thank you. Okay, so we're going to use a large one in polished pink because this is a big butterfly. And then I'm going to take one medium and then a small. Okay, so these will be graduated here. And I just color the rhinestones. Our pearls, you can color our pearls too. Okay, now we're just gonna add this to our beautiful butterflies right here. And we have matching jewels. Can you color vellum so you can do other colors too? Yes, yes, if you have clear vellum, you can use your any color blends and color it. Then take them back after he reads them to keep them on my display shelves. That's so sweet, Peggy. So here is where we've colored our jewels. I love that. Okay, let's do this pale papaya. And let's see. We're going to do like a medium right here and two smalls. Medium and two little smalls. Now this is really, really light. But once it gets on the butterfly, you'll see it. Sometimes I come back in and I give it another little coat. But pale papaya is a light color. So pretty. Okay, so now we're gonna put this, place this here. Look how nice that looks. It's like a gold. Look at that. Oh, that's so cute. Now you can see that they're colored. Thank you, Kelly. Yeah, you can always color on vellum, always. Now we're going to use our fresh freesia. And let's see, I think I need another medium here, don't I? But we'll put three small. Let's put a large. I want a large one. Oh, I use my brush tip. Wait. Use a nib tip. It gives it a little bit deeper color. Then I'll go too small. Cute. Then I need too small. I know. Sandra, you're right. You know, I used these butterflies with clear vellum, the plain vellum before, which of course you can, I'm going to color two of these. You can use and color vellum. And, but I really love this shimmer. I'm hoping they keep the shimmer. I'd love for them to keep the shimmer. So we're doing, fresh freesia right here. Cute. Two, and didn't I do a third? Oh, here, I did a big one. Let's move that one down. Here we go. And there's our little purple one. Oh, thank you, thank you. This came out so cute, so cute. I'm gonna move these around just a little bit. That's the nice thing too about vellum is that you can pick these things up. Kind of move them a little bit. Right there. Oh, that's so cute. Okay. And now our two small, right here. We're going to put that on our big thanks. Cute. Oh my goodness. I just love that. I love this shimmer vellum. I think for Sunday, we're going to do, layering flowers with the shimmer vellum, and then you know where I've kind of been monochromatic with it, a little, you know, just one color. I think we're going to layer colors. I'm not sure yet, but I think that's what I'll do Sunday. Okay, now let's go ahead and flip these guys over and place some dimensionals on them. We'll put two on each, one on each side of each wing, so that the cardstock part of the butterfly stays down, and then of course that'll allow the vellum to pop up. Yes, plain vellum and add some Wink of Stella. Try. You can color plain vellum. Okay, so I want my larger one down here where my pop these up. Okay, isn't that cute? I want that down there where my sentiment is. See, and I want those wings flat. Then I'm gonna put this one here. Pop that up, oh cute. And then this one up here flying. And I've just used, oh my goodness. Look at that, it's a butterfly garden. What time Sunday? 7 p.m. My Sundays are at 7 p.m. Let's go ahead and make our envelope. And this is just beautiful. I love to make an envelope like this. This is just scrap paper. Evening Evergreen. Here's the front of my envelope. I checked, okay? I checked. Because you could really make a mess. And now I've mounted just this part of the stamp, see? This part of the stamp right here onto this e-block. Thank you, Lynn. And now I'm going to take ink to stamp. Let me get in camera. Ink to stamp. Oh, thank you, Beverly. I had so much fun with all these butterflies. Okay, now I'm going to stamp this down here. Isn't that beautiful? Now I'm gonna fold my flap out. Cause see, I used the paper cause I'm stamping off. And I'm just going to ink this up. And fold the flap out. And there we go. That makes a very bold envelope. I love that. You know the postal person is like, wow, look at that. So, yeah, I love butterflies. So glad to keep the butterfly set in our annual. I agree. I had to look yesterday. I was like, what butterflies do we have? So this is what I have come up with for today. Just look at how pretty. Okay, now you could always, if you wanted to put like petal pink or polished pink on fresh freesia, you can mix them up. That's an easy peasy way also to get some great color. You can also, thank you, Sharon. You can also stamp your butterfly black and then put your butterfly vellum on top of it, which will look stunning. Oh, thank you, Joan. This is today. And then yesterday we made a basket of flowers with this shimmer vellum. So that's what I'm showing this week, is how to use your shimmer vellum. Just different ways to do it. I hope you enjoyed this card. Thank you. Yes, I think the black would look great. The background paper is Bloom Where You're Planted. Is that what it's called? Yeah, Bloom Where You're Planted. I'm still getting used to all the names. But it is the opposite side of what we used yesterday. Just the opposite side of it. Oh, yes, thank you, Kelly. The envelope comes out so great with those big, bold butterflies. Aren't they great? And just stamp them off, just like they're flying. Thank you, Marie. I appreciate it. The swaps are mailed, guys. I'm so excited. I hope you guys like all the cards and everything. I've already made a video, but you all post when you get your swaps. This way, then, I will post the video on my Happy Crafting Corner for us to watch. That's wonderful for my team. I appreciate everyone. I hope you've enjoyed this card today, and you might try to make some pretty little butterflies with some shimmer vellum, or color your vellum and make beautiful cards. I mean, this is just so pretty. So putting stamps on the front of the envelope, wait a minute, okay, Peggy. So putting stamps on the front of the envelope doesn't interfere with the mailing address. No. No, they don't stamp. That's why I don't stamp. No, it doesn't. I would put an address right here and a return right here and a stamp right here. And I think you're just fine. Yeah, I've never gotten anything back because I've sent something that has stamped. Oh, yes, the blending brushes are great. Mm-hmm. Oh, thank you, Donna. Thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Yes, the any time that you can color, you know, clear vellum, you go right ahead. And yeah, that's a lot of fun because you can color it all different colors. You know, you can make your butterfly tricolor. You know, you can use you could use these three colors if you color plain vellum. It will look so cute. So there we go. This is our card for today. I will definitely see you guys on Sunday at 7. We'll make another beautiful card. Thank you, Paula. And using the shimmer vellum this week. And yeah, we'll just have a wonderful day today, okay? I hope everyone has a wonderful day and you can get to your happy space and do a little bit of happy crafting sometime during the day. Yes, just give it plenty of time to dry. You're exactly right. Yep. Yeah, if you, Lynn made a good point right there. If you stamp on vellum, just stamp and walk away. Okay? Stamp and leave it. And you can, just for a minute, just for a hot minute. You just can't, like if you're on white paper like this, you just can't stamp and then cut it. Okay, just stamp. Hi, Becky. And kind of leave it for just a minute or two and let it dry. And then you can punch, roll it through the stamp, cut, and emboss machine. No problem, but just give it a second to dry. That's for sure. All right, everyone, please have a wonderful day. And let's all do some happy crafting today. Thanks again for watching.